गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड डिस्कशन ऑफ हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो दिस इज हाइब्रिडाइजेशन टू. इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन वन. देयर वी हैव कवर्ड सम मॉलिक्यूल्स. नाउ विल जस्ट एक्सटेंड दिस डिस्कशन टू फर्दर सम मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो आवर फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज PCl5. So first you draw the structure of PCl5. So now how many sigma bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In PCl5 there are 5 sigma bonds is present surrounding the phosphorus. So the hybridization will be 5 sigma bond. So the hybridization will be sp3d. So 1s 3p 1d, so in total 5. So the hybridization will be sp3d. Again I am saying, whenever we are deciding about the hybridizations, it's the art of counting of number of sigma bonds and lone pairs, not the pi bond. So here 5 sigma bonds are present, so the hybridization will be sp3d. Now we'll switch over to sf6 molecule. This is our sulfur, is the here central atom. Now we will draw the structure of SF6. So around the sulfur, how many sigma bonds are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. 6 means 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2 equal to 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. Third example is the sulfur trioxide. So what is the structure of sulfur trioxide? S double bond O. So now how many sigma bonds are present surrounded by sulfur? 1, 2, 3, and these are the pi bonds. Whenever more than one bonds are present between the two atoms, one bond will be sigma, others will be pi. So here between sulfur and oxygen, two bonds are present, so one will be sigma and other will be pi. So in total, surrounded by sulfur, three sigma bonds are present. So the hybridization will be sp2. Now we'll switch over to xenon tetrafluoride. You know, xenon is the zero group elements. In the outermost orbit, xenon has 8 electrons. So accordingly, the structure will be xenon tetrafluoride. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 electrons are utilized. Now 4 more electrons are pending. So these 2, 4 electrons remains as a 2 electron pair here. So now we'll count down the number of sigma bonds and lone pair. Here how many sigma bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sigma bonds and 2 lone pair. Now writing here, there are 4 sigma bonds and 2 lone pairs. So in total there are 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2, 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. That means in xenon tetrafluoride, the hybridization of xenon is sp3d2. Now we'll switch over to XCOF4. Now the structure of xenon oxyfluoride is, this is xenon, this is the structure of the xenon oxyfluorides. Now how many electrons are being utilized? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One lone pair is pending. So now we'll count down the number of sigma bonds and lone pair. This is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond. Among the two bonds, one is sigma, one is pi, and one lone pair. So total number of sigma bonds are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sigma bonds. 5 sigma bonds are present and one lone pair is present. So in total there are 6. So 6 means the hybridizations will be sp3d2. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2 equal to 6. sp3d2. Now we'll switch over some typical examples like NO2 plus. So here this is the structure of NO2 plus. Here over the nitrogen lone pair, that's why here one positive charge. And now we'll count on the number of sigma bonds. This is one sigma bond, this is one. So in total there are two sigma bonds. So two sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp. Similarly, if we will discuss about the NO3 minus, then NO3 minus ion structure will be, this is the NO3 minus ion. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no lone pair of nitrogen. So now we'll count on the number of sigma bonds. This is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is pi bond, pi bond. No need to count out the number of pi bonds. So there are three sigma bonds. There are three sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp2. And our last example is sulfate ion, SO4 2 minus. So now we'll write down the structure of SO4 minus 2. So 1 O minus O minus, this is the structure of sulfate ion. So here the number of sigma bonds are 1 2 3 4. These are the two pi bonds, no need to count down. So the number of sigma bonds are 4. So 4 sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp3 3p1s. So sp3, the hybridization will be sp3. That's all. These are the few examples I discussed in this lecture. In the hybridization part 3, we will extend the discussion furthermore. Okay, goodbye. Good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about the second discussion of hybridization. So this is hybridization 2. In the first lecture we have discussed about the hybridization 1. There we have covered some molecules. Now we'll just extend this discussion to further some molecules. So our first example is PCl5. So first you draw the structure of PCl5. So now how many sigma bonds? 1 2 3 4 5. In PCl5 there are 5 sigma bonds is present surrounding the phosphorus. So the hybridization will be 5 sigma bond. So the hybridization will be sp3d. So 1s 3p 1d. So in total 5. So the hybridization will be sp3d. Again I am saying, whenever we are deciding about the hybridizations, it's the art of counting up number of sigma bonds and lone pairs, not the pi bond. So here 5 sigma bonds are present, so the hybridization will be sp3d. Now we'll switch over to sf6 molecule. This is our sulfur, is the here central atom. Now we'll draw the structure of sf6. So around the sulfur, how many sigma bonds are present? 1 2 3 4 5 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. 6 means 3 plus 1 4 plus 2 equal to 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. Third example is the sulfur trioxide. So what is the structure of sulfur trioxide? S double bond O O. So now how many sigma bonds are present surrounded by sulfur? 1 2 3. And these are the pi bonds. Whenever more than one bonds are present between the two atoms, one bond will be sigma, others will be pi. So here between sulfur and oxygen, two bonds are present. So one will be sigma and other will be pi. So in total, surrounded by sulfur, three sigma bonds are present. So the hybridization will be sp2. The hybridization will be sp2. Now we'll switch over to xenon tetrafluoride. You know, xenon is the zero group elements. In the outermost orbit, xenon has 8 electrons. So accordingly, the structure will be xenon tetrafluoride. So 1 2 3 4 electrons are utilized. Now 4 more electrons are pending. So these 2 4 electrons remains as a 2 electron pair here. So now we will count down the number of sigma bonds and lone pair. Here how many sigma bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 sigma bonds and 2 lone pair. Now writing here there are 4 sigma bonds and 2 lone pairs. 2 lone pairs. So in total there are 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2, 6. So the hybridization will be sp3d2. That means in xenon tetraphyllite, the hybridization of xenon is sp3d2. Now we'll switch over to XCOF4. Now the structure of xenon oxyfluoride is, this is xenon, this is the structure of the xenon oxyfluorides. Now how many electrons are being utilized? 1 2 3 4 5 6. One lone pair is pending. So now we'll count down the number of sigma bonds and lone pair. This is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond. Among the two bonds, one is sigma, one is pi, and one lone pair. So total number of sigma bonds are 1 2 3 4 5 5 sigma bonds. 5 sigma bonds are present and one lone pair is present. So in total there are 6. So 6 means the hybridizations will be sp3d2. 3 plus 1, 4 plus 2 equal to 6. sp3d2. Now we'll switch over some typical examples like NO2 plus. So here this is the structure of NO2 plus. Here over the nitrogen lone pair, that's why here one positive charge. And now we'll count down the number of sigma bonds. This is one sigma bond, this is one. So in total there are 2 sigma bonds. So 2 sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp. Similarly, if we will discuss about the NO3-, then NO3- ion structure will be, this is the NO3- ion. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no lone pair over nitrogen. So now we'll count on the number of sigma bonds. This is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is one sigma bond, this is pi bond, pi bond. No need to count out the number of pi bonds. So there are 3 sigma bonds. There are 3 sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp2. And our last example is sulfate ion, SO4 2-. So now we'll write down the structure of SO4-2. So 1 O- O-. This is the structure of sulfate ion. So here the number of sigma bonds are 1 2 3 4. These are the 2 pi bonds, no need to count down. So the number of sigma bonds are 4. So 4 sigma bonds. So the hybridization will be sp3 3p1s. So sp3, the hybridization will be sp3. That's all. These are the few examples I discussed in this lecture. In the hybridization part 3, we will extend the discussion furthermore. Okay, goodbye.